The White House released a statement yesterday seemingly pulling out of northern Syria, saying that the U.S. will no longer be in the immediate area of northern Syria to allow Turkey to take care of ISIS fighters. In that statement, he called out our allies, France, Germany, and other European nations, saying, "The United States government has pressed France, Germany, and other European nations, from which many captured ISIS fighters came, to take them back, but they did not want them and refused. The United States will not hold them for what could be many years and a great cost to the U.S. taxpayer." Trump then went on to tweet, "I was elected on getting out of these ridiculous endless wars where our great military functions as a policing operation to the benefit of people who don't even like the USA. The two most unhappy countries at this move are Russia and China because they love seeing us bogged down, watching over a quagmire, and spending big dollars to do so. When I took over, our military was totally depleted. Now it is stronger than ever before. The endless and ridiculous wars are ending. We will be focused on the big picture, knowing we can always go back and blast." He also said, "As I've stated strongly before, and just to reiterate, if Turkey does anything that I, in my great and unmatched wisdom, consider to be off limits, I will totally destroy and obliterate the economy of Turkey. I've done before. They must, with Europe and others, watch over the captured ISIS fighters and families. The U.S. has done far more than anyone could have ever expected, including the capture of 100% of the ISIS caliphate. It is now time for others in the region, some of great wealth, to protect their own territory. The USA is great." I had the pleasure of getting invited to the White House a few weeks ago, and one thing that really stuck out to me that President Trump said, he said something along the lines of, he wants to make our military bigger and greater, and he said the bigger it gets and the greater it gets, the less he actually has to use it. I really believe he thinks with this philosophy. He's not a warmonger.
Well, I'm the one that talks about these wars that are 19 years and people are just there. And don't kid yourself, you do have a military-industrial complex. They do like war.
Whether it be Mitt Romney, McCain, Clinton, Obama, Bush, he's doing what none of them would have done, which is de-escalated the Syrian war. I reported about a year ago or 2 years ago when no one else was, that he actually cut a covert intelligence community operation that was funding rebels in Syria. And then a year later, all of a sudden, there is no great refugee crisis. The refugees can go back to their home country of Syria. And the ISIS caliphate that the news fear-mongered about for years, ISIS, ISIS, North Korea, North Korea, two of the biggest issues that they fear-mongered about, he pretty much got rid of. Let's check out some things he's retweeting on his Twitter. Kurt Schlichter, "Turkey is invading northern Syria. The president is keeping us out of it. The gang that never met a war they didn't want to fight and failed to win will be outraged. When they howl, ask them one thing. Ask them exactly how many American lives it's worth. I say zero." Gotta respect that. He also retweeted Hugh Hewitt saying, "Turkey can't win a war with Kurds, but if it does, we can't be killing Turks with Americans throughout Turkey, our base there. Some will cast any deal with Turkey as real Donald Trump gets closer with a dictator. It's not. It's dealing with the realities that we can't stay forever." Check this out. Facebook alerted me that 6 years ago today, I shared this meme. "Yeah, if we could just not invade any more countries before we straighten ours out, that'd be great." That's how I feel. We have a lot of work to be done in America. When Trump said, "Make America great again," I was hoping that it meant, hey, let's focus on ourselves instead of running all over Iraq, Iran, Syria, Libya, and trying to be the world's police. Trump's actually doing that. You could say he's not doing enough. You could say that you would do more in his position, I guess. But I think one thing that's undeniable is Trump is progress. He's definitely not starting the war that Hillary Clinton wanted to start and that Obama started and that probably a Mitt Romney and a John McCain would have liked. Mitt Romney doesn't like his move. Lindsey Graham is mad at this move. I'm sure Ben Shapiro is very frustrated by this. And weirdly enough, you see a lot of anti-war liberals that would have been anti-war 2-3 years ago, all of a sudden now are acting like endless regime change war is good. I'll be looking for Tulsi Gabbard since she always talks about ending the regime change wars and loves to call out Trump, which is fine, but seems to whisper his successes or not acknowledge them at all. Personally, I like what he said as well. He said that because a lot of people are saying, well, Turkey's not a good ally, Turkey isn't loyal, but Trump is saying, listen, I'm going to destroy their economy if they do the wrong thing. So he's not just letting them run rampant and do whatever they want. He's saying, try to do the right thing. And this is what Trump is really great at. The United States is extremely powerful. We have the most powerful military in the world. We have the most powerful economy in the world. A lot of other countries operate off of us, whether it be financially or military-wise. Trump is not a warmonger. Trump is not a dictator. Trump is not pro-war. He's actually the most anti-war president I've ever seen in my lifetime. Obama, Bush, whether it be Clinton, Romney, like I said, these other neocon conservatives, they all are obsessed with war. They're obsessed with regime change war, whether it be Iraq, whether it be Libya, whether it be Syria. We've done some real damage. We've exacerbated problems. We've created new problems. Syria's Christian population was about cut in half. So for all the Christians that say, oh my God, it's the Muslims, we gotta stop them from Syria was a Christian stronghold and a secular stronghold in the Middle East. And after our presence there, it didn't do the Christians any good. And until President Trump, it was getting worse and worse and worse and worse. If we have the strongest military in the world, how were we not able to defeat ISIS? How were we making problems worse? It's because a cold, rude awakening that people needed is, I don't think that we were actually trying to solve any of these problems. I think certain people in government, like Trump said, had an agenda that had nothing to do with the United States, had nothing to do with the taxpayers, had nothing to do with safety and security. But there's other war agendas out there for people who want to do things not for me and you or the people of Syria or the people of Libya. And Trump is the real deal. I get it, the counter argument, you could say that there's still conflicts in the world that Trump hasn't completely solved and that maybe he's supporting or funding. But like I said, it's progress. I don't think the world is going to be peaceful in a day or a week or maybe ever, to be honest. But he's making massive progress, and a lot of these quagmires, whether it be Syria or others, in many ways it's a lose-lose where you could do one thing, but it doesn't necessarily mean there's going to be peace and the fighting's going to stop. But I'm super proud of our president, and I'm pumped that we finally have an anti-war president who's doing what he said he would do. He said he would get rid of the ISIS caliphate. He virtually did that. He said he would pull out of Syria. He's done that more than anyone else. He continues to execute, and these warmongers and his haters on both sides of the political debate never stop trying to destroy him and put him down. Even Colin Powell came out recently and said, the Republican Party needs to get a grip or something of that sort. I think it's translated to mean, we need our grip back on the Republican Party because we've lost grip of both parties. We've lost having full security over the Republican Party, where no matter who wins, whether it's Romney or the other Republican, you're going to get the same war agenda. You're going to get a very similar domestic agenda that does maybe a little thing here or there, not like Trump where he's changing deals. He's pressuring countries to pay us or give us fair deals. I mean, you could not like the guy personally. You could not like his attitude. You could not like his words and his tweets. You could not like him. You could even not like his policies. I don't really care. But you can't deny that this guy is a revolutionary. He's very, very different from any politician we've ever seen because he wasn't a politician before. He's calling out the media, which in my personal perspective is one of the most disgusting energies on the planet. They nonstop just push fear, 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 pharmacy pill, fear, fear, fear. They invert reality. They've lied to us about the settled science for decades, whether it be food, medicine, or environment. He's calling them out. He's calling out the warmongers on both sides. It's really awesome. I love it. What do you think? Let me know your perspective. Have a good week, and I'll be back with more videos. If you would like, sign up to my free email list. It's going to be in the comment section. And if you'd like to support, there's a way on Facebook, their little supporter tab. I have a Patreon, a donor box. I have Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Ethereum if you'd like to go that route. And if not, just have a good day. I know some people are like, Anomaly, I don't want to help or I can't help. That's fine. It's a suggestion. It's not a demand. I'm doing great. Thanks to your help. Thanks to your likes. Thanks to your shares. Thanks to your comments. And thanks to the energy that you share with me. So that's more than enough. Thank you so much.